In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of hippocampus. In first part, I'm going to explain anatomy and function of hippocampus. And the second part, I'm going to explain related structure with hippocampus. Okay, where is hippocampus? You are looking the brain from anterior view. And the left hemisphere and the right hemisphere is removed. I just put left hemisphere of cerebrum, see? Then let me remove hemisphere. Now you can see hippocampus. This part is temporal lobe. Hippocampus is very deep to temporal lobe, okay? So hippocampus is very, very deep structure. Let's look at each structure. This is hippocampus. This light green structure is hippocampus. Main function of hippocampus is short-term memory. Like what you ate for breakfast, what you did for morning, what you ate for lunch. Like, you know, short-term memory. That's very important structure. Then there are many other functions like learning and studying. Main function is short-term memory and learning. This is very important structure. Now let me explain associated structure with hippocampus. What is this dark green one? This is dentate gyrus. Sometimes you can combine dentate gyrus and hippocampus together and you can call this structure as hippocampus. But you can separate. You can separate this part as hippocampus and this part as dentate gyrus. You can combine or you can separate. Function of dentate gyrus is very interesting. Of course, it has a function about memory, but it is believed neurogenesis happens in dentate gyrus. What is neurogenesis? Neurogenesis means the body creates new nervous cells. I think it's quite interesting. Neurogenesis happens in dentate gyrus. Okay, now let's go to red structure. This is choroid plexus, this red structure. And this white structure is fimbria of hippocampus. Now let's follow the hippocampus. Remember, this part is hippocampus. This light green structure continues. What is this structure? This is fornix. Fornix is the main output fiber from hippocampus. Main function of fornix is memory. However, the function of fornix is not very well understood yet. I think this is mysterious structure. Hippocampus then becomes fornix. Quite interesting. Now let's look at this red structure. This is not part of hippocampus, but its function is very similar. What is it? This is parahippocampal gyrus. Para means, you know, next, right? Para means next. Parahippocampal gyrus is very close to hippocampus. The function of parahippocampal gyrus is scene recognition. Like you recognize the landscape, cityscape, the scene of room. I think this is very important function. Let's review the anatomy. This light green structure is hippocampus. Then hippocampus becomes to fornix. Dark green structure is dentate gyrus. Neurogenesis happens here. The white one is fimbria of hippocampus. Red structure is choroid plexus. Now, let me explain relationship with other structure. In today's video, I'm going to explain with ventricle. This is ventricle. This is ventricle. Now, where is hippocampus? Hippocampus now hidden. That means hippocampus is below the ventricle. Okay, here is how you remember. The name of hippocampus is from Greek mythology. Okay. Seahorse. Okay. Where is seahorse living? It's under the ocean, right? And this is ventricle. What's inside of ventricle? Cerebrospinal fluid, right? Fluid fills ventricle. Fluid. Now, hippocampus is under the ventricle. That means hippocampus lives under the ocean. This is how I remember. Hippocampus is under the ventricle. I remove ventricle. Now, you can see hippocampus and dentate gyrus. Today, I explained basic anatomy and function of hippocampus and related structure. This area is so important for memory, learning, neurogenesis, and many other things. I am quite amazed, you know, this area. I think this is fascinating place. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.